I want to talk to you this morning from another aspect of from the beginning it was not so. And we're going to look at speaking in tongues today. Speaking in tongues today. From the beginning, God never intended for tongues to last until 2012.
Right, sir.
We have for the past few months been looking at some things that God never intended to take place religiously. We began by looking at role reversal as something that God never intended to happen. For we studied that the Bible teaches that from the beginning, God never intended for men to act like women, nor for a woman to act like a man. We not only looked at that, but we noticed and talked about ritualism in religion. And we noticed that from the beginning of mankind, God has always commanded his people to serve him in sincerity and truth, rather than just doing something because some man said that this is what ought to be done. We also studied the fact that God never intended for us to wear different names religiously. From the beginning, God has always given his people a name that he wanted them to wear. And we notice that some of these names that people wear religiously cannot be names that God wanted them to wear because he didn't even mention them in the Bible.
Amen.
God always gives names that represent his people and say something about who they serve. Therefore, we studied the fact that the name Baptist, Methodist, Presbyterian, and Catholic, and so on and so forth, cannot be names that represent people who serve God, because those names have nothing to do with God. Not only that, but we also studied that God never intended for there to be more than one way for a man to be saved. From the beginning, God has always had two major elements involved in the saving of mankind, and that's blood and water. And the only way to come in contact with the blood is to be baptized in some water. We also understood from the Word of God that God never intended for there to be more than one church. From the beginning, God has always planned to have all of his saved in one place. And that place is the church that was built and purchased by his son, Jesus Christ. Then upon last week, we studied the fact that God never intended for miracles to last forever. From the beginning, God has always used miracles to give confirmation to the word that his holy men were speaking unto the people. We noticed and studied the fact that when unbelievers would hear the word of God spoken by the men of God, and then they would turn around and witness the power of God displayed with a miracle by the hands of the man of God, then that unbeliever would become a believer in God, and they would in turn obey his word. Yes. So we studied the fact that the Bible teaches us emphatically that God used miracles to confirm his word. But once that confirmation period was over, then God did away with that miraculous activity. God was going to bring about a time when his word would in fact be confirmed. And that brings us to our lesson for this morning. Now that we know that there was a purpose for miracles, confirming the word of God, and we also studied the fact that there was a period of miracles during the time that God was confirming his word, then we understand this morning that the miraculous ability to speak in tongues were also coupled with the miracles that God did away with. Amen. Tongues, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 12, and beginning at verse number 10, is grouped in the same category as the working of miracles. The Bible says that God gave to another the working miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another diverse or various kinds of tongues. Notice even in this passage, we find biblically that the ability to speak in tongues were a miraculous ability. This was not something that was happening through the course of nature, but the ability to speak in an unknown tongue was something that happened supernaturally by the power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. And if God has done away with miracles and tongues were a part of the miraculous manifestation of God's power that he used to confirm his word, at the same time God did away with miracles, it was the same time that God did away with tongues.
Amen.
Now I'm gonna help you with that this morning.
All right.
Because we got some folk who are claiming even today in 2012, they have the ability to speak in tongues. And there are people who are claiming that they either spoken in tongues or they've heard somebody speak in tongues. And what I want to show you from God's word is that the ability to speak in an unknown tongue was a part of the miraculous manifestation of God's will. And if God did away with one of them, yes, he didn't leave the other one hanging around. Amen. Let me put it a little bit plain. If nobody can walk on water today, then nobody can speak in tongues. Hello in here. If nobody can go to the hospital and clear out the ICU ward of the hospital, then you don't have anybody speaking in tongues. The ability to perform miracles and the ability to speak in tongues were all a part of God's way of confirming his word until his word was complete in his written form.
Yeah.
And we studied last week that even the Apostle John said there were so many other things that Jesus did, which I did not write in this book. But John said, I wrote enough in here. Oh yeah, I wrote enough in the book so that you might believe, and that believing you might have life through his name. Folk are looking for a sign. Even Jesus said in Matthew 12, an evil and adulterous generation seeketh after a sign, and ain't no sign going to be given to it.
That's right.
He's already given you everything that you needed to see. Everything you need to hear. Nowadays, faith doesn't come through the working of a miracle. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. If God did away with miracles, then he had to have done away with tongues. Look back with me at chapter 13. And beginning at verse 8, let me remind you of what you've already been taught. Charity never fails. Whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, this is miraculous knowledge. Wouldn't all of us love to be in a position where we would just know the Bible backwards and forwards without having to study it? That was during the time that God had the miraculous gifts existing. That's what they could do. God would give it to them miraculously. They didn't have to study. He would give it to them. As a matter of fact, Jesus told his disciples that when you are brought before kings and men, for my sake, take no thought what you're going to say. For it shall be given to you the same hour what you shall speak. Because it's not you that's speaking, but it's the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
We would love to have that power. But we don't have it. Which is the reason why even the Apostle Paul told Timothy to study.
Yes, sir.
To show yourself approved unto God. You're going to be right with the Lord. You got to study. Yes, sitting around tearing on the Lord to give it to you. He's already giving it to you.
Yes, sir.
You just ain't reading it.
Yes,
you follow me? And so the Bible informs us that tongues were going to cease. That miraculous knowledge was going to vanish away. For